Department here in the U.S. is disputing a report by some House Republicans about the attack on the U.S. outpost in Benghazi. As we reported here last night, Democrats call it a one-sided political report. The attack killed the U.S. ambassador to Libya, Chris Stevens, the State Department official Sean Smith, and two former Navy SEALs, Tyrone Woods and Glenn Doherty. According to the House Republican report, former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton personally rejected requests for more security at the Benghazi facility. Before leaving office, Secretary Clinton testified she did not see those requests, but one House Republican tells Fox News he stands by the GOP's report.
I don't know what her eyes saw. What I do know is that her signature is on some of the denials of those requests. And what we know for certain is that some of these requests did not end with the security folks in the State Department. They went higher, up into the management levels.
State Department spokesman is responding and saying it is standard protocol that cables originating from the State Department in Washington go out under the authority of the current Secretary of State, with their signature, i.e. their name, typed at the bottom. In this way, Secretary Clinton signed hundreds of thousands of cables during her tenure as secretary. The security cables related to Benghazi did not come to her attention. These cables were reviewed at the assistant secretary level. The death